family of killer whales has inspired generations to care about our natural world, and we're excited to share their story with you today.
Killer whales are the
as a group. It's just another reason why they are known as the ocean's top predator. Their scientific name is Orcinus orca, and their common name is the killer whale. Our five whales have their own personal names. Our two males who you just met are Trua and Matayo. And our three females who are joining us right here are Katina, Nalani, and Malia. Matayo is our youngest whale. He is just 12 years old. His mother, Katina, she is our oldest. This year, she celebrated her 46th birthday! Katina is also the matriarch of a whale pod, which means that she is the leader. Now, these whales here at SeaWorld, they trust us, and they take an active role in their own health and well-being. Through the use of positive reinforcement training techniques, we can teach them a variety of husbandry behaviors. Now, husbandry, that's just a fancy word for health care. And one of the first behaviors that we teach our whales is called a food present. This is where the whales present their tail flukes to their trainers. Just as our three lovely ladies, our two lovely lady trainers, and Nick are going to demonstrate today. Not only does this allow us to get a great look at the whale's entire body, but it also allows us access to the easy-to-see shallow veins that are located on the white undersides of their tails. Our team of veterinarians can collect blood from these veins at least once a month, or whenever needed, and the whales are conditioned to remain calm, just as you see Katina, Nalani, and Malia demonstrating for you all now. Now, throughout today's experience, you'll see the whales getting rubdowns on different parts of their bodies, like their back, their pectoral flippers, and even their tails. These animals have very sensitive skin, so this is just one of the ways that we can build a strong relationship with them. But collecting blood is only one way we can ensure the health of our whales. Another important diagnostic tool is weighing our whales, and in order to weigh them, we ask them to slide their entire bodies out of the water onto a whale-sized scale, just like Malia's going to demonstrate in our slide-out area in just a moment, hopefully. That's actually a great chance to talk about what happens to whales don't do something that we necessarily ask them to. That's totally okay. So Malia, I don't think Malia saw Nick asking for that hand signal there. He was asking it in a different way than we usually do. He was giving her what we call a hand target, but he asked her again and she saw it that time, so here she is in the slide out. But you'll notice a portion of her body from her dorsal fin down to her tail flukes remains in the water. This part of the body is called the peduncle, and it is the powerhouse of the killer whale. It's packed with powerful muscles and it weighs several hundred pounds. So with it in the water, we wouldn't get an accurate weight. So to fix that, we simply ask the whales to lift their tails up and out of the water, just like this. And that's how we know that Malia here is tipping the scales at over 5,600 pounds. Weighing our whales is important. It helps ensure that our younger whales are growing appropriately and our older whales are maintaining a healthy weight.
And the care isn't just physical. Mental stimulation and play are vital, and we surprise and engage with our whales at every opportunity. Play is how killer whales teach their young to hunt, and for the adults, play is important too. It seems that they just enjoy having fun. Making time for play is an important part of life for killer whales and for us.
Hello again, everyone. I'm down here at the glass on the left side of the stadium, and we're going to talk about killer whale learning. Killer whales can learn in a variety of ways, and observation is one of them. Oftentimes, we see them playing fun games with their mother and other members of their pod to learn new things. And today, we're going to put that to the test with the help of all of you. Are we ready to have some fun? Alright, I want that right there. So we're starting off on the left side of the stadium. We have Harper who's going to help lead us, everyone, so go ahead and stand up. When I let you know, you're going to put two hands up in the air and give Nalani a big wave. Ready? One, two, three. And she's got it! Nicely done, everyone. You can take a seat out of the water to get a better view of their surroundings. And I believe Malia here is going to demonstrate that out of the stage with a behavior that we call a sighting bow. She's building up some speed to launch herself into the air. Here she comes. This is Malia. All right. We're moving on over to the right side of the stadium. I cannot forget about you good people. We got my man Bo who's going to help us out. Everybody stand on up. But I'll let you know, you're going to take two hands and throw them up and to your left, just like that. You ready, Bo? All right. One, two, three. All right. Katina saw you, Bo. Come up to the glass, man, and watch. She's going to make her way down to the bottom of this 36-foot deep pool. It's full of icy cold 52 degrees. populations of killer whales.
That can grow
and change the world.
Together, we've got this.
Ladies and gentlemen, we hope that you enjoyed Orca Encounter.